So what exactly is the difference between a rotating and a sticky session? And when should you choose one over the other? Let's find out. Long ago, proxies came in lists. The problem was that half of the proxies in those lists were dead before you even started using them. But if you successfully left the 90s, you're probably already familiar with a thing called rotating proxies. A rotating proxy is a proxy server that automatically assigns you a new IP address from a proxy pool for every connection you make. Talk about taking your web scraping to the next level, right? So when you choose a rotating session, you get just that. Your IPs will change automatically with every new connection request. This means that you'll have one IP address when you open the website, another one when you open a link, and so on. Rotating sessions are great for web scraping and price or product monitoring. But what if you need the same IP address for a bit longer? Then you choose a sticky session and your IPs will rotate slower. So even if you reload the website or do any other action, your IP will stay the same until the session expires. Use sticky sessions if you need to manage social media accounts or make retail purchases. Okay, so now you're probably wondering, how long can sticky sessions last? Well, Smartproxy's data center proxy sessions last for 30 minutes, and our DDC proxies will let you hold the IP for an unlimited amount of time. As for residential proxies, it all depends on your authentication method. With user pass authentication, you can quickly choose a session length from 1, 10, or 30 minutes. However, if you want to have a custom session duration for a period in between that 1 to 30 minutes, let's say 14 minutes, you can easily do that by specifying the session duration parameter. And as for the whitelist authentication, it will let you hold onto your IP for up to 10 minutes. Want to know how to select your session type and set up your proxies? Then watch this video and see how it's done using our Chrome extension. For more instructions, visit our documentation. You'll find the links in the description below. Till next time.